Hi everyone, this is a tutorial from dwviconcepts.com. In this tutorial, we will demonstrate how to create a batch job using SAP Business Objects Data Services. So let's get started. Here is the agenda for this video, and we will go straight directly to Data Services Designer. So here is our Data Services Designer graphical user interface. Here we have the project area and the local object library. Now first of all, we need to create a project. So in order to create a project, we go to project, new project. Let's name it as DWBI Concepts. This is our project name. So create. Okay, we have our project created. Next, we need to create a batch job within this project. Okay, right click, new batch job. Let's name it as job underscore customer stage. Okay, so when we double click the job, this is our workspace of the job. So what we will have in our workspace inside a job, we can have a data flow or a workflow. Let's create a workflow. We click on the palette and again click on the workspace and let's name it WF underscore customer stage. Okay, here we have our workflow. So a workflow can be used to keep some data flows together. Next, we click the workflow and we introduce a data flow inside the workflow. So let's name it DF underscore customer stage. So this is the data flow that will contain our source, the transformation logic, and the target. So next, go inside the data flow. Now we need a source table. So what I will do here is that I will take advantage of a data services transform row generation with which we can generate rows of data and we will populate our target. So let's click the row generation, drag and drop on the data flow workspace. Let's keep the name as row generation. Now we double click to change its property. Here the row number starts at say 1 and the number of records I am expecting 10,000 records. Okay, let's validate the transform. No errors found. Fine. Okay, we go back. Next, what we need to create is a query transform. This is the most widely used transform in data services. We can drag from the local object library and drop it on the data flow workspace. Else we can use the from the tool palette. Click and again click on the workspace. Let's name it query underscore extract. Okay. Now join it with the row generation transform. Next, we check the properties in the query transform. Okay. So this is our input schema and this is our output schema. Now let's suppose we want to define a customer table, target table, and we want some fields like customer ID, customer name and load date. Okay, so right click, new output column. Let's name it cust ID. I want it to be an integer data type. Okay, and in the mapping we want a sequence number. So the DI row ID of row generation transform will give me sequence number from 1 to 10,000. So let's drag and drop it. It will be mapped. Next, define a new output column. Say cust name. This would be a varchar data type. And let's make the length 100. Okay. So how I will define my customer name? Let's to make it generalized. Let's say we want our customer name as cust underscore one, cust underscore two, like that. Okay. So cust and concatenate the pipe operator and then drag the di row id. So it will give me cust underscore, let's put underscore, cust underscore one, cust underscore two, and so on. Next, we want to create a load date column, new output column, insert below, say load date, and the data type would be date. Okay. And what will be the mapping criteria? We will use the data services function sysdate. Okay, here we go. Now let's try to validate the query transform. We got an error. So let's check what's in the error. So first, these are warnings, not errors. So the first warning, it says a conversion warning. And the next one, the data length mismatch. Okay, so what we will do, if we check the customer name, here we are using a integer and we are placing it into a varchar. That is an implicit conversion. So if we explicitly convert it to varchar, to char. So let's see whether, oh, no errors found. Okay, so we are able to handle our warning. So let's go back. Next, we need a target table to stage the customer data, that is the customer ID, customer name, and load date. For that, we need a table in a database. So in data services, in the local object library, we have a data stores. Data stores are the connection objects. It holds the connection credentials to a database. So let's create a database. I have a database in Microsoft SQL Server. So I right click on the data stores tab, new. Let's name the data store as DS underscore TGT target repo. The data store type is database and the database type is Microsoft SQL Server. So what is the version number? I have 2008 as my version. Let's put the server name, the database name, TGT underscore repo, and the login credentials. Next, we click on apply. Okay. So here our data store is getting created. Next, when we click on the data store, what are the things we can see is a function which basically implies the database function or procedure, the tables, the database tables, and the template table. Template table are special tables which are actually get created from a data services job. These are a placeholder table. It actually gets the structure from its previous transform. And these tables are normally drop and create tables. So why there are no tables in my data store? Actually, we need to import the tables by name or reimport all. In this particular example, I'll use a template table. So let's drag the template table and drop. So it will ask me for a name. Let's name it customer stage. Okay. Now if we double click on the property, oh, we get an error. Cannot drill into this object. You need to connect an input schema. So this template table expects a input schema, which will be the definition of its output schema. So let's connect the query transform to the template table. And now when we double click to check its property, okay, this is how our target table will be created in the database. The table name is customer stage, the owner DBO, and the columns customer ID, customer name, and load date. Let's check what's in the options. If we check in the options tab, we will found that this is a drop and recreate table. So every time we change the mapping, we introduce new columns, this target schema will change and correspondingly a new table will be created in the database. That is, a table, existing table will be dropped and recreate it with the new structure. So let's go back. Now we need to validate with whether our defined data flow is perfect or not. So we click on validate all. No errors found. So we are good to go. Next, we need to run our job to initiate the data flow. Jobs are the only executable objects in data services. So right click, execute. Okay, we need to save all our objects we have created so far. Yes, save all changes. And this is our job server, which runs the extraction, transformation, and loading of the data flow. And we click OK and see what happens next. Okay, this is the monitor. Here we get the trace log, the monitor log, which shows the number of records and the time elapsed. And there is an error tab. So if we encountered any error, the error will be logged in this error tab. So what's the trace message says? That the job completed successfully. So let's go back and let's view the data. Okay, here our customer 1, customer 2, and the data what we expected has been loaded successfully. So this is how we will create a simple job using SAP Business Objects Data Services Designer. For more tutorials on BODS, please visit dwbiconcepts.com. You get more tutorials on data warehousing, business intelligence, ETL, as well as reporting. Thanks for watching this video.